Okay, so basically, Poland does not want to take any migrants and refugees from the Middle East and Africa. And the criticism there is that because Poland is a very homogeneous country, only 0.3% of your population of 40 million is made up by foreigners, 91% of the population is Roman Catholic, and that therefore you don't want Muslim migrants. I give you an example of what the Deputy Prime Minister said in May last year, Jarosław Gowin. Poland shouldn't accept any Muslim migrants to prevent Polish babies being blown up. That's what he said. It's that kind of sentiment that people don't like about Poland.
There are some this kind of ideas exist also in Polish population, as more than 75% of Poles do not want to accept this relocation by force of the migrants from North Africa and Middle East. But we try to implement the decisions of the Commission from September 2015, and many months ago we sent our people, our border guards, to the camps in Italy and Greece. We sent also security officers. We try to identify some of these people, and of course majority of them is very difficult to identify. They do not have documents, and this is a threat for the security of the country. And of course no one from these migrants, or as you say refugees, we prefer to say migrants, had any inclination to emigrate to Poland.
Right, you made
so
that point.
We cannot accept the situation that this progressive, let me finish, that this progressive European Union is deciding about relocation by force, people who do not want to be relocated to the country like Poland.
Well, I put it to you that that's your position, but it's the sentiment that underscores what you just said that makes people unhappy about the comments that are coming from official Poland. For example, Jarosław Kaczyński, who is the chairman of the ruling party, said in April last year, explaining why he didn't want refugees, these people bring in diseases, parasites, bacteria that don't affect them but affect us. I mean, is that kind of comment acceptable, do you think?
Once again, I can repeat only that 75% of the Polish population is accepting policy of the country, of the government, not to accept the decision of the European Union to relocate by force or to resettle by force people from North Africa and Middle East.
Yeah.
And we don't want to commit suicide as the politician, as a government, and to go against the public wish about public sentiment, as you say.
All right, but you see the accusation, for example, a spokesperson for the Catholic bishops who are urging Poland to receive refugees from the Middle East and North Africa says that fears are being fueled by some political parties. And according to the Never Again organization, which tracks racist attacks in Poland, says they've increased considerably in the last year, and that the correlation is very clear between what we can call hate speech of the political class and those assaults. That's Rafał Pankowski from the Never Again organization. So there's a link. I put it to you just one more time. Are you happy with this state of affairs?
No, of course, we are not happy, and we discussed this issue, the problems of migrants and refugees, for instance, last year in Poland during the visit of Pope Francis. And Pope Francis visiting us delivered a speech in Krakow in Wawel Castle, and he mentioned that there are many ways to support, to help, to assist refugees and migrants. And he didn't mention that Poland is supposed to accept thousands of people from Syria or from the Middle East. Just opposite. I had the chance also to visit many times the Vatican and discuss with a hierarchy that the situation. And we all understand that we're supposed to first start helping, assisting people there in the region, in the Middle East and North Africa. First, we're supposed to engage as Europeans to find them, to help find them peaceful solution for the war, which is going on for already 7 years in in Syria. Right. Then we're supposed to control the borders of the European Union. Finally, we're supposed to help them to relocate, of course, in Europe, but on a voluntary basis. Those countries who have the ability to accept these migrants may accept them, and those who want to emigrate to the country are supposed to emigrate. But we cannot accept in 21st century resettlement by force.
All
and
right.
Once again, we are accepting millions of migrants coming
sure.
from Ukraine and Belarus. And
you
we're supposed to remember that Poland is finding these people in Poland.
All right, you made that point, thank you. But all these things that we've been discussing have really drawn a lot of criticism from the European Union of Poland. And look, Poland is the biggest net recipient of EU funding. In 2015, for example, alone, in 2015, you received 13.4 billion euros in EU funding. You can't afford to fall out with the EU, can you?